everyone in your Google Chat app to react in real time to new messages in a space, track user activity, or even bridge communication across different platforms? Well, that's where the power of Google Chat Events comes in. In this video, you will learn how you can work with events from Google Chat. A Google Chat event represents an activity or change in chat, and it is like a signal, letting your app know when something interesting happens in a chat space. It could be anything from a new message posted in a chat space, a user joining or leaving a space, or even someone reacting to a message with an emoji. By tapping into these events, your app can become proactive, responding to changes in real time and creating a more interactive and engaging experience for your users. Now, how does this all work under the hood? Well, every activity in Google Chat affects a related chat API resource. For instance, when a user posts a message resource is created. Chat then creates an event that contains data about the new message. Chat categorizes events by type. Event types help you filter and receive only the type of information you need and let you handle similar activities in the same way. As we saw before, a user posting a message in a chat space means a message resource is created and is of event type new message. When a user becomes a space manager, the membership resource is updated and chat creates the update membership event. A user reacting to a message triggers the creation of the reaction resource and the new reaction event. When a user leaves a space, a membership resource is deleted and the event type is deleted membership. To configure your chat app to receive events, you have two options to choose from. You can have your chat app subscribe to events using the Google Workspace Events API to receive events as they occur. Or your chat app can query for recent events by calling the chat API. If you've built your chat app using AppScript, you can use the chat API advanced service. Note that there are differences between these two options. When you subscribe to events using the Google Workspace Events API, you receive the events as Google Cloud PubSub messages that are formatted according to the cloud event specification. The event data is a base64 encoded string with or without resource data. When you query for events using the chat API, you have access to the event in the form of objects on the chat API resources. The event data is a JSON payload that contains resource data. Let's have a look at two examples to identify when to subscribe to events versus when to query for events. In the first example, a chat app wants to send a welcome message to users as they join the space to explain the space guidelines or share tips about how to effectively use the chat app. To receive events in real time, the chat app calls the Google Workspace Events API subscriptions.create method to subscribe to the space for all types of membership events. After creating the subscription, the chat app can start processing membership events. If you want to learn more about how to work with the Google Workspace Events API, check out the video Subscribe to Google Chat Events linked in the description below. In the second example, a chat app posts a weekly message with a summary of the space's membership activity in the past 7 days. To achieve this, a chat app calls the chat API spaces.spaceevents.list method. In our example, 3 membership events occurred, and so the chat API returns a list of these space event resources that represent each of the membership changes for the app to process. Want to learn more about working with events from Google Chat? Then check out the developer documentation linked in the description. Leave us a like if you've learned something new in this video. And may I suggest you subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you can stay up to date with all things Google Workspace platform related?